day that the Lord hath made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. If this is your first time, make sure you let us know in the comments. Make sure to also like and subscribe to the City of Grace. We're so glad that you're here to join us on today. And come on and make sure you magnify the Lord with us as we exalt his name together.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. Praise the Lord. Good morning, City of Grace. Good morning, East City. We are so glad that you are here for this morning's worship experience. And now that you are tuned in, can we go ahead and bless the name of Jesus together? For the Lord is good and his mercy endures forever. And we ought to go ahead and praise him. We ought to put our hands together because God is good. So right now in the chat, somebody drop, "My God is good." And if you're in the building, go ahead and shout, "My God is good. My God is good." So we want to go ahead and sing about the goodness of our God this morning. So even in your home, begin to clap, begin to dance, begin to shout, "God, you're good. Lord, you're great."
The final say. She has the final say. And the
praise that we can give. There is nobody like our God. There is nobody better than our God. There is nobody greater than our God. And because our God is good, he deserves every hallelujah. Because our God is good, he deserves every, Lord, I thank you. Because he's good, he deserves hand raised. He deserves the fruit of our lips right in this moment. Can we begin to think about the goodness of our God? Lord, you've kept us. Lord, we're in our right mind. We are alive this Sunday morning to give your name praise. And as we give your name praise, as we talk about your goodness, we want these praises to rise. We want them to rise so you can hear them, so you can feel them. It says, let praises rise from the inside, from the inside of me. May you delight in the inside, in the inside of me. Come fill my life from the inside, from the inside of me. Set me on fire from the inside, from the inside of me. 'Cause all I want is for you to be glorified, you to be lifted high. All I want is for you to be glorified.
Yeah.
For you to be glorified.
thank each and every one of you for your kindness and your generosity. We pray the blessings of the Lord make it rich and that he added no sorrow onto it. And at this time, please direct your attention to this morning's announcements.
Welcome to the city.
Parents and children, join us for Virtual Children's Church, Sundays at 10 a.m. on Zoom. Grace for Kids is dedicated to partnering with parents to lead children to become fully devoted followers of Christ. If you or someone you know is in need of food, please join us Tuesdays from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. for the city's food pantry. Join us as we fast and pray corporately as a body every Wednesday. Our Hour of Power corporate prayer is held weekly on Wednesday evenings from 7 to 8 p.m. We invite you to intentionally turn your plate down as we lift our prayers up. Our life class continues, a purpose-driven life, taught by our very own Bishop Melda Williams. Questions you'll receive guidance on include, how do I know that I'm hearing from God? How do I know the will of God? How do I know what my purpose is? As well as distinguishing fear versus faith and much more. The series continues Wednesday evenings at 8 p.m. on Zoom and Facebook platforms. So that's all for this morning's announcements. At this time, please receive our senior pastor, Overseer David Law.
Amen. Well, praise the Lord to each and every one of you. God bless you. Amen. On this blessed Sunday morning, we thank you for joining us. We thank you for being a part of our worship experience. We do salute each and every one of you near and far. To our each city members, we thank God for you. We honor your presence. We are grateful for you. And we thank you for joining us. To each and every one of you, wherever you're tuning in from today, we want to say to you, welcome. God bless you. This is the day the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad therein. Amen. Very quickly this morning, as we get ready to go to the word of the Lord, amen, we want to celebrate, we want to honor. For those of you that are joining for the first time, we say welcome. Amen. For God is good. His mercies are everlasting, and his truth endured for all generations. Very quickly, turn with me to the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 3. 1 Samuel, chapter 3. And we're going to read a couple of verses this morning. 1 Samuel, chapter 3, from verse 7 on down to verse 10. Amen. Amen. The word of the Lord is still our compass. Amen. Our Bible is still our guide. So why don't you turn with me, even if you're watching virtually this morning, and let's read the word of the Lord. For the word of the Lord is still quick, and it's still powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword. Amen. And the word of God reads thus wise. It says, now Samuel did not yet know the Lord, neither was the word of the Lord yet revealed unto him. And the Lord God called Samuel again the third time. And he arose and went to Eli and said, here am I, for thou didst call me. And Eli perceived that the Lord had called the child. Therefore Eli said unto Samuel, go lie down, and it shall be, if he call thee, that thou shalt say, speak, Lord, for thy servant heareth. So Samuel went and lay down in his place. And the Lord God stood and called as other times, Samuel, Samuel. Then Samuel answered, speak, for thy servant heareth. And this morning I want to speak to you for the subject matter, hearing God. Hearing God. Somebody put it in the comment section, hearing God. It's time to hear God. Throughout the Old Testament, God spoke to his people through many sources. These sources were men and women who would have life-altering encounters with God, followed him speaking and hearing him audibly, as he did in Exodus chapter 3 when he spoke through a burning bush, saying, "Moses, Moses." Whenever he spoke, it was not just for a common conversation, but God's communication with man was purposeful and fundamentally threefold. Firstly, there was information he needed to share with them. Moses goes to God and he says, "Whom should I say sent me?" God responds to him, "Tell them I am that I am." He wanted to share a part of his characteristic with Moses and with Pharaoh. Secondly, there was instruction that he needed to convey to them. "Noah, I need you to build an ark because it's getting ready to rain. Build it according to the dynamometers and the dimensions that I give you, specifically because I need you to bring two animals of every kind into this ark." And thirdly, there was inspiration that he needed to allocate to them. "Come here, Joshua, be strong in the Lord and very courageous. Be not afraid." And here, brothers and sisters, the same God that was mentioned in the Bible, in the Old Testament and the New Testament, that spoke at sundry times according to the book of Hebrews, is the same God that speaks to us today. He might not come to us audibly and saying, "Thus saith the Lord unto you," but he's a speaking God. He's an ever-talking God. He's a God that gives us instructions, and he's a God that gives us information on how we ought to live life. He's a God that gives us inspiration when we get weary and when we get tired. And here in the book of Samuel, we find the same relational God, talking God, speaking to us again. He shows up again, brothers and sisters, because he has something that he wanted to say. This book of the Bible now not only stands as proof that God speaks to us, but also that he hears us. The very word Samuel, brothers and sisters, translated in Hebrew to God hears. Why do you say that? There was a woman by the name of Hannah that was barren in many ways, and the Bible tells us she continued to pray to God until God heard her cry unto him, and God answered her and gave her a Samuel. So she said, "I'm going to name him Samuel because God heard me and responded to me." No wonder the psalmist writes in Psalm 116, "I love the Lord because he heard my voice." Can you testify very quickly in the comment section and tell somebody, not only does God speak to us, but he hears us? This book now is self-titled and presents to us a man by the name of Samuel. He was one of Israel's greatest prophets. He would lead them into many victories, as he did in chapter 7 at Ebenezer. "For hitherto had the Lord helped us." Somebody help me in here this Sunday morning. He was feared by many. He was revered by many nations. He was a vital part of the operation and administration and the historicity of the monarchy. He anointed two kings for Israel. He saw God move and he heard God speak to him. He had many
encounters with God. But here in the beginning of the book of Samuel, we find this man of God. Before he did any remarkable works and before he did any outstanding things for God, we first find him in the house of God, learning to hear the voice of God. Let me digress right here to tell somebody today that you can't do great exploits for God if you don't know how to hear the voice of God. You can never move beyond your own limitations and expectations if you don't know how to hear the voice of God. The Bible lets us to know now that Hannah, the mother of Samuel, had given him up to Eli to live in the house of God and to be trained as a Nazarite. But she did not even understand that Eli would train his own replacement. And that's a whole different sermon right there. So he lived in the house of Eli. And brothers and sisters, the best way for you to hear God is firstly to create an atmosphere in your home where you can detect the voice of God, where you can hear the voice of God, where you can understand the voice of God. Can you put it in the comment section this morning and tell somebody, I'm getting ready to create an atmosphere. And he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me that I am his own. And the Bible lets us to know now, brothers and sisters, here in the text, we find two distinct characters. Firstly, there is a man by the name of Eli, the symbol of a mature Christian who stands as an intercessor, because the job of the priest was to go to God on behalf of the people. And I've come to tell some intercessor that you can't be an intercessor if you don't know how to hear the voice of God. Secondly, now Eli, our brothers and sisters, the text tells us that he's lost vision and is losing the ability to hear God. So God sets up a replacement in the form of a man by the name of Samuel. I feel like preaching this morning. And the second character we find in the text is a man named Samuel, a symbol of a young, immature Christian who really don't understand how to hear God's voice. One that represents somebody that's developing the ability to hear God's voice. And that's the two people I come for this morning. The ones that's lost the ability to hear, and the ones that need to hear what God said. The Bible now lets us to know here, brothers and sisters, that as Samuel begins to grow, he hears God's voice clearly. And the Bible tells us now, here in the text, that these two characters, the one that could no longer hear and the one that was developing the ability to hear, are found in 1 Samuel chapter 3. There are three points I want to leave with you as I get ready to leave this morning about hearing the voice of God. The first point is that you cannot hear God if you have no relationship with him. As you read in verse 7, it tells us that Samuel did not know God, and that the word of God was not revealed to him yet. So until you develop a relationship with God, you cannot hear him. Until he is revealed to you, you cannot hear him. So somebody ought to put it in the comment section and say, Lord, teach me how to love you. Teach me how to hear you. Reveal yourself to me that I can hear your voice. And the second point this morning is that there are times that God will speak through us through a familiar voice. Why do you say that? God comes to Samuel and he speaks to him three times. Samuel gets out of his bed and he runs to Eli's room and said, "Here am I, Eli, for I heard you called me." You see, the voice of God sounded like the voice of Eli. And that's when God's trying to train you on how to hear him. How many of you know that there are times when God will speak through you, through the voice of somebody else? I wish I had somebody to help me. Isn't that what he did with Moses when he went to Pharaoh? He didn't go to Pharaoh himself, but he spoke to Moses, saying, "Let my people go." And thirdly, as I get ready to close, God will keep speaking until you give him a response. God came to Samuel not three but four times, and the Bible tells us that Eli, this priest that had lost the ability to hear, says to Samuel, "I needed to go back and lay down, and if you hear the voice one more time, I need you to give him a response." And God comes back to Samuel, and he didn't call him one time, but he did like he did with Moses with the burning bush. Moses, and says, "Samuel, Samuel, I got something to tell you today. I want you to hear my voice, because when God mentions your name twice, it means he's got something to say, and you got to pay attention." Samuel understood now that he heard the voice of God and did like his master told him, and he said, "Here am I, Lord, speak, Lord, for your servant heareth." And when you hear the voice of God come knocking at your door, you got to do like Samuel did and say, "Speak, Lord, your servant heareth. I'm in the right posture now. I'm in the right position now. I know how to delineate between your voice and Eli's voice." Oh, I need somebody to hear me in the room this morning. Could you put it in the comment section and tell somebody, "I'm in the right posture. I know how to hear God. He's calling me one more time. He's knocking at my door. So my response today is, speak, Lord, your servant heareth." In other words, what Samuel said is, unblock my ears and take me to another dimension of hearing what thus saith the Lord. Could you do me a favor? I got 2 seconds to wrap this up, but can somebody today put it in the comment section and say, "Speak, Lord, your servant heareth. I need you to talk to me. I need you to speak to me. I've got to hear your voice. I need you to unblock my ears, cut loose my tongue, remove every obstacle where I can hear you clearly and hear you on another dimension. Lay hands on your ears and do like Samuel did and say, speak, Lord, that sermon heareth." Is there anybody in this sanctified virtual church that can lift your hands and say, "Speak to me"? If you don't speak to me, I don't know where to go. Speak to me. If you don't talk to me, I mess my life up. Speak to me. If you don't talk to me, I make some bad connections. Speak to me. I need somebody to help me here in the sanctified church. Lift your hands, open your mouth, and put it in the comment section. Speak, Lord, that servant here is. Hear me.
I gotta go.
got to get out of here. But I come this morning for somebody in the room that needs to develop the attitude and the ability to hear God's voice. He's an ever-talking God, and he's been speaking to you. But all you need to do this morning is lay hands on your ears and give him a response like Samuel gave him, and just tell him, speak, Lord. Today I decree over your life that the voice of God is about to become so audible in your spirit that you will hear God on another dimension. You hear him on another level. You will be able to decipher between the voice of a man and the voice of God. Come here, Eli. Hey, in the name of Jesus, I decree spiritual maturity that will come to hearing God's voice. The more mature you become in the spirit, is the more you hear him. And the more you hear him, is the more you obey him. I need somebody to help me, help me, help me, help me, help me. I need a Samuel in the room this morning. In the name of Jesus.
Speak, Lord, for your servant hears. Samuel had to learn to decipher the voice of man from the voice of God. But God understood that he would not be able to recognize because of his immaturity in the spirit. So he comes to him through a familiar voice that sounded like Eli the priest. But he understood after a couple of tries, this is not Eli. This is the voice of God. And today I decree over your life that you will not only hear the voice of God, but that you will obey the voice of God. To those of you that are watching today for the first time, watching and don't know the Lord as your Savior, I pray that something that was said, a word that was spoken, will ignite your heart to desire to know him the way we do. It's very simple. All you have to do is lift your hands and ask him to come into your heart, come into your life, and save you. And just like that, he'll be a part of your life. Lord, just repeat after me. Lord, I give you my heart. I give you my soul. And I ask that you have your way in me. I confess you as Lord. And I ask that you save me. Be my Lord. And be my Savior. And just like that, you are saved. Connect with us. We want to hear from you, that we can become a part of your journey as a Christian, to help you become who God has called you to be. God bless each and every one of you. And until next week, we are intentional about hearing the voice of God. If we hear his voice, we harden not our hearts. So we give God all honor and all praise this morning in the name of Jesus. Come on, wave your hands in your living room. Wave your hands and give him praise. Just take a couple seconds just to worship him as we get ready to leave here. Come on and give him your hallelujahs. Come on, give him your hallelujah. Come on, give him your hallelujahs. He deserves it. He deserves it. Come on, give it to him. Come on, he deserves it. Come on, he deserves it. Come on, lift your hands. He deserves it. He deserves it. Come on, lift your hands and worship him. He deserves it. How many of y'all know he deserves it? Come on, lift your hands and sing my hallelujah. My hallelujah.
to you. Come on, lift your hands and just tell him, my hallelujah. Come on and worship him. Come on, it's an act of worship. My hallelujah belongs to you. Hey. Belongs to you. Come on, lift your hands in the sanctuary of your home and say, my hallelujah belongs to you. Hey. Now come on, lift your hands and tell him, you deserve the Lord, you deserve it. Hey. You deserve it.
You deserve it.
From the bottom of my heart,
you deserve it.
You deserve it, Lord.
You deserve it.
Come on, one more time, you deserve it.
You deserve it.
The Lord make his face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and may he give thee peace. Come on, lift your hands and worship him. He deserves the Lord.
Have you said yes to God today? If you have, we invite you to text the number that is on the screen. And if you haven't, you still have time in this moment to consider inviting God into your heart and into your life. If you do, we celebrate that step that you've taken. Text the number that's on the screen and we'll definitely be in touch to continue to pray you through this brand new journey. And if you're a returning virtual viewer, we invite you to text City Guest to the number that's on the screen. Text City Guest to the number that's right below. When you do, you'll be plugged into the city and you'll get notifications that all the other city changers get. And until next Sunday, have a blessed week, City Changers. Bye.